you two soft skins that my head crown could rip off your crown jaw.
I bet you three that it couldn't.
You can share in my victory.
Think you're strong? Prove it!
Someone's sneaking about.
That fellow!
ought to come down off that catapult and fight me face to face. Not like a coward. That attack knew it couldn't stand up to me.
Noruk.
Close by.
You sound worried. Better not be, or I'll save the ranger the trouble of dealing with your sorry ass.
Take it from me. You don't want the ranger testing out his witchery inside your skull. Can face a true Uruk. Are there any true Uruk here? You are unfit to lead.
What? Did you hear that?
Who do you serve?
damage one of our hunters did to us.
Stomach and muscle required for war.
Even if they did, they don't have the leadership to do much of anything.
Spears obviously the best weapon. You got reach and you got shot. What else is there?
Torvin!
Heads up, Captain! Time to go hunting! A deadly hunter needs a deadly man!
Careful! This one's ready for lunch!
You're gonna have to break it! I'll keep you on your toes!
I'm sure that is!
I assume you know the path.
The real question is, are you ready to travel it? Whatever happens during the hunt, think, what would Torvin do?
Actually, that's a good life lesson for you to follow always. I pray your training sticks, or else you'll stick to the wall once the mighty Grog hurls you there.
I'm ready to fight the Grog.
And that's just what you do. Fight. No art, no finesse. The hunt isn't about swinging and slashing, it's bigger than that.
From your perspective, Dwarf, everything is bigger.
Yes, this Grog is very, very big. Oh wait, you're mocking me. Graugs are one of the oldest species of Mordor, and the deadliest by far. It's been a long time since I faced this Graug. Let us hope time wasn't as gentle to him as it was to me. My old partner and I once tracked a Graug from Mount Dolmed to Nogrod. We finally slayed it and got stuck under his leg for 2 days. Ah, those were fun times. Last time I saw the beast was when my old partner and I tracked it into his dwelling.
How did you get out alive?
Luck. The Grog knocked me senseless. When I came to, it had ended my partner. Facing that creature alone was a death sentence. I'd been hunting this Grog for almost a decade. And that's a lot of years of dedication to one beast.
Dedication? Or a sign you preach better than you hunt.
Oh, that's funny, Captain. I'll be sure to laugh when the beast eats you alive. The mighty Grog will be my legacy. Dwarves will tell tales of Torvin the Hunter for generations. And I'll have them throw your name in there somewhere.
Whoa!
The Karagors are too quiet. I don't think the Grog is home.
Then we go in and we wait.
An ambush? How military.
I like it. It's an axe.
That's just as sharp as the day our father made it.
A shot to the skull will disorient him.
Yeah. Let's just do as Torbin said. Rule number one, we... Never mind, we improvise! It's too strong! I must attack from afar! A shot to the skull will disorient him!
think he's dead.
Well, that's what I call beast hunting, eh?
Indeed, indeed.
Next time I'm not going to let you have all the fun.
Oh, no, no. This is the last time. I have other prey to pursue.
Well, you need help on your journey, so what do you say? We put
No, Torvin. I have to do this on my own.
If you survive, come to the Blue Mountains, eh? Lots of friends that will drink until their kegs run dry.
I've seen how much a dwarf can drink.
I do hope our paths cross again.
Right.
Now how do I get you out of here?
The hour grows late. Very soon, the Dark Lord and his army will march all over Mordor. But a great power can be awakened to prevent it.
Is that why I'm here?
That Torvin finds his way home now that his hunt is over.
If he does, then he will find his home is not as he left it.